What's up, everybody? Episode 4 of The Falcon and Winter Soldier just dropped on Disney Plus, so let's review it. Real quick, this is a spoiler review for the episode, so if you haven't seen the episode yet, you have been warned. And if you enjoyed the video, don't forget to like and subscribe. Also, leave a comment down below. Tell me what you thought of the episode. Anyway, let's get on with the review. Also, this episode was fairly simple and straightforward. Falcon, Bucky, and Zemo are in some city. I don't recall the city. But they're investigating the Face Smashers. Like last episode ended, the people from Wakanda, they're after Zemo, and they're like talking to Bucky and stuff, and they're in this episode as well. There's a scene where Falcon's trying to reason with Carly, who's like the leader of the Face Smashers, and he's making progress and like trying to come to common ground. And then the new Captain America, he shows up, and then he kind of messes things up, and then they get into a fight. Throughout the episode, it's kind of teasing that like, the new Captain America, he's not strong enough because he's just a human. And it's kind of playing with that arc and that idea that he wants to be stronger. So, like I mentioned, in that scene, Face Smashers drop all their serum on the ground to make super soldiers. So Zemo starts destroying them because he thinks it's wrong, and that's like kind of his point of view on the situation. But he misses one, and then the new Captain America gets it, and so he keeps it, and he's kind of contemplating whether or not he's going to use it on himself throughout the episode. And then by the end of the episode, he did decide to use it. So now the new Captain America is now a super soldier. And then there's an action scene, and he's like really powerful now, because he's already like a really powerful soldier. He just didn't have that like super strength and stuff that the serum gives you. So now he's like really powerful in terms of like fighting. So during this like fight at the end of the episode, Carly accidentally kills his friend. I don't recall his name. He accidentally gets killed. So then the new Captain America sees it, he gets really upset, and so like since the serum like magnifies your emotions, he kind of like loses control of himself. So he chases down one of the Face Smashers. He's trying to get to Carly, but he catches this guy. So he ends up killing him with his shield, just like bashing him in. And meanwhile, everybody, there's a huge crowd around him recording what's happening. So obviously like they're gonna be like, oh, Captain America kills someone in the middle of a street. So that was a really like intense and crazy end to the episode. But now let's get on with the review. So overall, I actually really enjoyed this episode for the most part. The plot for the show really has me intrigued, and it's really intense and like really complex. Like, there's multiple point of views, and all the point of views make sense, and it's really deep, and it's really like kind of like a political thriller, and it's really done well. And they keep mixing these action scenes in there to try to keep the show fresh, and I like that. It really feels like, you know, Captain America and the Winter Soldier, and I like that. It's definitely different than the usual MCU project. You don't have all these superpowers and everything, which I like. It's just, it's refreshing, it's more realistic, and it's just written really well, I think. And I think that's probably the best thing about this show, is it's written really well. The characters, the dialogue, it all just feels really genuine, and it's just well made overall. And I'm having a good time with this show so far. In this situation with the Flag Smashers, it doesn't feel like any of the characters are right in the situation. It all feels like they kind of, you can feel their point of view, but you can feel all their point of views. It doesn't feel like there's one right answer to the situation. And that's what's very political about it. That's very political, you know? There's lots of disagreements and stuff like that. And it makes it very complex and almost confusing at times, but I like that. It just keeps you interested in the show. I really am enjoying the new Captain America's character. He's kind of this like very complex hero slash becoming a villain, I guess. Maybe he's going to be the villain, who knows? Who knows where this is going to lead? But I really like his character. I think he's a really good actor. I don't know who's playing him, but he's doing a really good job playing him. And it's just, overall, I really like this character. And it's definitely one of the most intriguing MCU characters, I think, because you take this guy who's a really good soldier and you put him in Captain America's suit, and he has to live up to these expectations when there's literally no way he can live up to those expectations. That's a really good concept, in my opinion. I love stuff like that. I love stuff about like potential and just trying to be better. And, you know, while this is a lot more complex than that, now he's used the serum and now he's like a super soldier. I've really enjoyed his concept, and his like conversations with his friend in this episode were probably my favorite scenes in the entire episode. I'm just like really just like deep conversations, and it just makes the show better and makes you feel for their characters a little bit. And I've never thought of them as the villain. They're kind of more, these guys are kind of in the wrong situation and in this complex situation. So obviously now he killed someone in front of everyone, so that's going to lead to a lot of consequences. I'm not sure exactly what those consequences will be. but we'll certainly see next episode. Definitely going to be a lot more political, as you know, everybody saw him do that, and there's going to be all this like, oh, what about Captain America? And you know, is he bad now? But just overall, I'm really digging the political drama and the plot in this episode. And the characters are really interesting. All the characters. I really like that they brought Zemo back. I think his character is interesting. He has another point of view on the situation, from different backgrounds, and everybody's got different ideas about different things. And it just, that's what makes this show very intriguing to me. I think the action in the show looks good when it happens. Like, I really like kind of the raw action in, just people beating each other up. There's no like blasters and superpowers and lasers and all that. Just people punching each other. I like that. It's more satisfying to me to watch than watching like Iron Man just blow people up. No disrespect on Iron Man though, but I think the action's pretty good. Though I will say I don't think there's been enough action. I know the show was always going to be this political thriller kind of thing. And doesn't need to have action, certainly, but when you have characters like Falcon, where you only care about really his superhero thing, where you only care about his superhero gig, you don't really care about, you know, Sam. You want to see him fight. So there's two solutions: either just have a lot of action or make us care about Falcon as a human. And I don't think they've done a really good job with that. And overall, for me, Falcon's been the biggest disappointment in this show, because I was really excited that it seemed like he was going to be getting his own show, or at least his own like half show with Bucky. But so far, it's just been, you know, he's kind of just this guy that's there, kind of in the middle, kind of trying to keep the other two groups apart. And Bucky's kind of like that, but I feel like he's a little more involved in the situations. But I don't think Falcon's really done much this series. Episode one, he had this really good action scene, but other than that, it's just, you know, I don't think there's been a lot to do with Falcon, and that's kind of disappointing. Hopefully that will change. I'm sure that will change, but right now I want more Falcon than what we're getting. Not more Falcon, but more of him actually doing stuff that matters, rather than just being in the middle and talking to people and kind of having like meaningless conversations that kind of just give us plot details and just progress the story. But overall, I'm still absolutely enjoying the show. I have no problem with the lack of action. Like, I have seen some other people have complained about the lack of action and entertainment. I have no issues with that. It just sometimes it feels necessary, and sometimes I wish the action scenes were a bit longer and a bit more drawn out. And actually, I wish they like meant more, where it just seems like they're fighting for fighting's sake. It doesn't almost seem like they don't want to have action, and they want this to just be like a drama series. So that's kind of, I find that kind of interesting. But I do really enjoy this show. I'm complaining a bit about it, but I'm having a lot of fun with it. So like I said, I thought this was a great episode overall. I thought it was paced well, and the character development in the show has been really good. I really like the new characters they've introduced us. I've so far, like Zemo coming back, I've liked what they did with him. I've liked Bucky's arc in the show. Falcon would be my only complaint of, you know, hopefully in the future it can be a little bit better and have more kind of exploration of Falcon. But overall, I'm having a lot of fun with the show, and especially I'm really loving what they're doing with the new Captain America. Definitely like a complex arc with him, and I'm really enjoying it. Definitely that's what I'm most looking forward to next week. And I thought episode 3 was a bit of a drag last week, and it kind of didn't really care about it. Kind of didn't feel like much progressed. So I was glad this episode really, I thought, picked up the pace a little, and it just, for me, it brought me back into the show, and I'm right back on board with it, and I really just can't wait to see what's next with this show. Alright, and that will do it for my review of episode 4 of Falcon and the Winter Soldier. If you enjoyed the video, don't forget to like and subscribe. Also, comment down below, tell me what you thought of the episode. What are you hoping for next week? What do you think's going to happen next week? And thanks for watching, and have a great day.